ninyo for next week, imo-move ko po ng mga ilang days yung submission, okay? So, for you to have enough or ample time to review with your lecture subjects, I know you are bombarded with workloads also. So, ayaw naman po namin ng mga Archie Lab subjects na sumabay. Okay? Anyway, let's start. I'll start with my PowerPoint muna. Sige. There you go. So, for ARCAD 312 midterm plate, we're going to have a particular ensuite bedroom. Nagagawa niyo po ng section. Now, for the interior section, you have two options. So, the first style option is the modern oriental interior design. So, let us define this. Instead na oriental or instead na Asian style, mas sinasabi siya as oriental. Okay? So, this one, Asian style or sometimes called oriental design, it showcases the cultures of Japan, China, Vietnam, Thailand, and other prominent Eastern societies. So, kasama po tayo doon because we are at Southeast Asia, okay? Some room designs are true to one style, while many Asian-themed rooms are a combination of two or more cultural influences, okay? So, iba-iba po yung approach natin when it comes to oriental design. Merong mas evident yung Japanese, merong mas evident yung Chinese, merong very Filipino naman, meron naman a fusion of both or multiple. Anyway, excuse for the tricycle background. There are several ways or tips to create an Asian-inspired interior, okay? So, di ba sabi nila, pag meron ka daw isang pares na malaking sandok or kutsara at tinidor na kahoy, you are very Filipino. Okay, pwede naman, pero I just find it awkward. But anyway, we have several ways to create an oriental ambience within our interior. Okay, so the perfect backdrop. So, this is a sample. Okay, meron siyang mirror, actually. Tapos, nire-reflect na niya yung reverse wall. Okay, so it serves also as a backdrop. A hint of vivacious color. We all know that Asian culture is very rich and tasteful. So, expect mo na talagang very colorful yan. Visual and texture balance. A cool water feature since marami pong mga tropical countries in Southeast Asia and in Eastern Asia also. We always integrate water features, be it artificial or kahit parang figurine lang siya na may water, we always... or marami po yung nag-a-adapt ng ganong feature. A fusion of styles, ito yung sinasabi ko earlier. Sculptural lighting and paper lanterns. I like this, paper lanterns. They are very Asian talaga, or the soji lanterns. Mamaya, may sample tayo. Organic and sustainable design. For example, in the Philippines, we are a tropical country. Therefore, we are experiencing a moody climate from time to time. Tapos, we are experiencing extreme heat on some months of the year. So, how do we deal with passive cooling? Diba? Kaya meron mga high ceiling, mga bigger fenestrations, okay? And fragrance of nature. We always incorporate indoor plants. Lalo na if you are into planting, diba? Nauso yung mga caladiums, yung mga family of, yung parang sagabi, something like that, okay? So, we always do that with oriental design. Now, what I have here are actually a compilation of some oriental interiors. Wait lang, may nagpapa-accept ata. Okay, so let's go back. Ayan po yung mga sample. Kinompile ko na po sila, but if you want to make a research about this or widen your research, mas maganda po. Okay, this one, you know, ganda, di ba? And this also. So, of course, cherry blossoms are very Japanese and Asian. pili na lang kayo dyan. Ang alam ko, kasama yan dun sa na-upload dun sa Google Classroom. Hey, this is very elegant, oh. Ang ganda niya. And this one also. Okay? So, look at the dark shades. Hindi ganun. Alam ng interior design na binalance yung paggamit na ng dark shade tsaka yung beige na mas dominant pa rin yung beige. So, hindi naging cluttered yung room. Okay, ito yung sinasabi kong backdrop. You can have a mural for that. And, ito pa po. This is also a nice backdrop and very modern. Okay. And of course, bamboo. Bamboo also is very abundant in Asia. So, it also represents the continent as a whole. So, you can incorporate that. Okay. And this, and this, and that. Okay? So, those were the samples for modern oriental interior design. Okay? So, we have another option. Dalawa lang naman po yung option nyo. Oriental, and the next one is Moroccan. Okay? So, maganda din naman siya. Pero I'm not into very intricate and elaborative designs. But, depende. Baka kayo gusto ninyo. But, still, I have included it on your options. So, what is Moroccan style? Okay? So, the Moroccan design style is all about color, texture, and fluid lines. They actually incorporate too many vibrant colors. Pero sabi ko nga, with the perfect use of contrast and balance, you can achieve a nice interior design. Okay, this design style draws much of its inspiration from the Moroccan Moorish design of the East and from the shapes and colors of the rolling sands of the desert. Its intricate beauty is seductive and inspires colorful and stylish interiors. Okay, and next one. So, ito po yung mga elements na ginagamit nila. They use stone, tiles, terracotta, wrought iron, textiles, and leather. Okay? So, hindi ko na po babasahin isa-isa. I will just be presenting a series of images from different interiors. Okay? This one is nice. So, this one is very parang pang-royalty. I also like this one. So, more on patterns sila, if you notice. Very intricate. And this one, also, although dito medyo a touch of patterns lang yung nilagay. But as you can see, very evident yung mga arches. Okay? Di yan arc, okay? Arches or arch. Iba si arc, iba si arch. Arc is the shape or the 2D object. While arch is the curvature in your structure. Okay, so this is very feminine. And this is, ano naman, parang, it's intended for a couple. But it's nice, although medyo dark lang siya. This one is very airy. And these are very elegant, okay? You can see these arches are very classic. And it's never, and having classic designs on your presentations will never be boring. And okay, we have more shadow na to. Let's fix it. Okay, so these are the samples. Again, I believe I was able to upload this file dun sa classroom. So, if you want to download it for your offline reference, you can do so. I like this one. Okay? Pwede siyang, ano, pambabae kahit powder blue siya. Okay? And this one also. Press kong tignan. Okay? So, again, it's up to you if you want the Oriental or the Moroccan. Anyway, both styles naman po are maganda. So, preference yun na lang po kung anong pipiliin ninyo. Okay? I'll stop sharing. And for the midterm exercise, so I'll present another window. Wait lang. Nawawala siya. Cannot present it. So, for a while. Okay. There you go. So, eto siya. This one is created in A3 size paper. Meron tayong floor plan. So, similar nung stair plan nung previous activity ninyo, we will also be uniform with this, okay? This is, sinend ko na po pala yung CAD file neto. Okay? Tapos, ang gagawin nyo po dyan is a section nyo. So, this is my sample. Okay? This is my sample of Oriental. From the section, this is how I present my section. I have hidden lines here, which represents my elevation. So, this is the finishing floor line. This is the ceiling line. Okay? So, yun lang naman po emphasize ninyo. Huwag nyo nang itanong kung saan may column, kung saan may ganito or ganyan. So, we will just be synonymous with this. Okay? Or identical. Now, meron din po siyang elevation. But, magvavary tayo dito except dito sa 2.7. Para pareho po tayong 2.7 sa elevation from finishing floor line to the ceiling line. So, dito tayo magvavary. For example, baka hindi naman kayo naglagay ng cabinet dito. So, you don't have to specify a dimension for that. Okay? And I have a mural. Yan. Let's see the specification. I have a Soji lamp. Yan. Which is actually after the shape of a pailu or an entrance gateway in Japanese architecture. Tapos yung nakikita nyo vertical slots, those are bamboo wall cladding, synthetic. I have modular cabinets, mga standalone cabinets. I have the Japanese mural painting. So, kung paano lagay yan, tignan natin later. I have a pendant lamp from the word itself, pendant, ibig sabihin nakahang. And plastered finish, CHB wall, 5-inch thick. Okay? So, ito po yun. That is section A. Pasensya na po sa spelling. Section A through A. And for the section B through B, so, let's see kung anong dinaanan ni section B through B. Ito kasi si A, eh. Okay? So, again, uniform po tayo sa floor plan. Okay? Finorward ko na po ito sa classroom. This is section B through B. Okay? So, dinaanan po niya yung sa may mini office at saka dun sa may bathtub area. Okay? So, let's go here. Dun pa rin tayo sa may windows for the bed area. Or bedroom, sorry. I have window railings which actually inspired from the Soji lamp. Ito yung Soji lamp ko. Or the paper lantern. Okay? So, hindi ko na sila ganong iniba. Although initially hindi ganyan yung design ko, but I don't want too many elements, so I just made them a little identical. Tapos this part is too rigid, so I incorporated some curved elements. Okay? Tapos kinapi ko na lang. Okay? And for the bathtub area, this is the bathtub, this part. Tapos meron po tayong wall tiles. So, let's see the specs. That is 0.30 by 0.50 ceramic wall tiles. Pwede pong rectangular sa wall tiles, pero sa mga floor tiles, preferably square. Okay? Medyo mabilis kasing masira pag rectangular yung floor tiles. Although, pwede naman. Kaya lang, yun lang napansin ko. Mabilis silang masira. And, for the bathtub itself, so, meron siyang pinaka parang partition for privacy purposes. Okay, para kung ayaw mo na shower curtain, I don't prefer shower curtain kasi if you're going to ask me personally, parang you can suffocate anytime. At saka they are prone to slippage. Pwede kang madulas or baka nadulas ka, humawak ka sa shower curtain, eh, hindi naman sturdy yun. So, if I really have the money, I will have a partition or a cover like this, okay? Meron siyang synthetic bamboo wall cladding ulit, which is resistant to moisture. Okay? And as painting. Okay? A Japanese painting or a painting of bamboo which represents Asia as a whole. Okay? So, I do hope kukuha po yung gusto kong makita sa midterm ninyo. Again, this is A3. Tapos, dun sa baba, makikita ko na po yung name niya. Wait, i-zoom in lang natin. Yan. Designed by your surname, given name, middle, initial. Okay, lagay niyo po ng year and section. And then, ARCAD 312 midterm plate. Okay? I used gradient for this. So, kayo na pong bahala kung anong gusto nyo gamitin gradient. Or kung gusto nyo artehan pa yung pinaka part kung saan naka-specify yung name ninyo, pwede naman po. Okay? Okay, I'll stop sharing. May question po regarding dun sa midterm plate. Before ko siya i-discuss. Or i-discuss ko pa ba? It seems alam nyo nang gawin. Of course, I will. Diba? So, sige. Aha. This is actually our last meeting for this year. Okay? Kasi next week, hindi ko na kayo umimit. Because you will be having a series of lecture examinations or written examinations. Okay? Anyway, let's start. As I have mentioned earlier, we're going to be uniform with the floor plan. Okay? So, let's just copy this. Dali natin dito. Yan. Class, pag ito, pinaste nyo dun sa existing CAD file ninyo na ginagamit nyo for our exercises, merong layer to. Layer na title block, tsaka AR2 hidden. Dinagdag ko po yun. So, mag-a-update po siya or dadagdag din sila doon. Okay? So, no need to set them. Pati yung layer ng walls. Okay, papasok din po siya dun sa file ninyo kasi ipipaste nyo siya doon. I'll just move this a little upward. Okay. There you go. And have my current walls current, a layer current. Okay, I'll just make a reference out of this. Tapat ko lang para pantay-pantay sila. Okay. And another line. Dapat ko lang para hindi na ako nag-detrim later. Okay? Tapos, L. Okay. So, I'll just have to... There you go. Let's see. My wall thickness is 0.15. So, let's offset. Or sorry, I just have to rotate pa pala this one. My apologies. R-O. It's 180. Yan. Okay. Tapos, I'll just move it. Track ko na lang yan. Okay, there you go. I'll move it higher pa. Because I need more space abundant taas for the specs. Yan. There you go. And, again, our wall thickness is 0.15. So, offset. Specify the distance. 0.15. Enter. Select. Paloob. Select. Paloob. Okay? And, punta ako dito sa may AR02 hidden. L. Enter. Maybe at a distance of 2. Okay. So, hindi nagre-reflect yung hidden. I have to check my LTS. Masyado siyang maliit for model space. So, I'll change it to 0.03 lang. Okay, that's better. Then, I need this arrow and this one. So, I'll just copy. I'll copy from the lot exercise. Lagay ko lang dito. Masyado malaki. So, with QP, enter, palitan ko siya. This one is 0.40. I'll just change it to 0.17. Okay. Not much. And I'll type FFL, which stands for finishing floor line. Gawa ako na rectang. Maybe 0.05, 0.05. Okay? It's too cute. Scale ko siya. Or maybe I'll create another one. Let's see. At 0.15, 0.15. Okay. There you go. Ang gawin ko na lang para may arrow ako, I'll select this grips. Adjust that. And there you go. Okay? So, that's my arrow. And I'll just move this somewhere here. Okay, and copy. And endpoint to endpoint. This one is ceiling line. But look at it. Ceiling line. So, naka-QP or mag-QP tayo. Select this. It's currently middle center. Okay, kaya ganun siya nung nag-type ako. It should be, justification is dapat nang gagaling siya sa left. So, palitan natin. Left. Okay, move ko lang dito. Sabihin natin line of ceiling. At least, di ba, dun siya nag-justify. So, you see the different justification in CAD? Okay, anyway, let's proceed. Next is, I have here, eto, I have shelves here, but if you're going to look on the section, eto po sila. I have bamboo wall cladding, which are, tignan natin yung thickness, 0.05, and distance of one to another is 0.05 also. But before that, I'll make my naka-elevate kasi yung bed. I wanted an accent lighting sana sa baba. Kung iti-3D mo siya, magandang tignan yun. And by the way, please, do keep your files, okay? Para, just in case na maging student ko pa kayo next sem for 3D, sila na lang po yung gagawin natin ng 3D model, okay? At least, you have the files, you don't have to start from scratch. Okay, anyway, I need muna to elevate. Naka-elevate siya ng 4 inches and meron siyang thickness na 2 inches. Okay? I'll switch my layer to AR03. I'll enter. Hanggang dito po yung naka-elevate sa may bed. There you go. Offset at 0.1. And offset at 0.05. Okay. So, I'll just trim this excess. And MA and select this two. Okay. And then punta ako ng AR01 and type REC, enter. So I'll pick from here. I-track ko lang po yung endpoint and type 0.05. Okay? Move ko lang siya. There you go. And I need hatch. Okay? So H, enter. Or sorry, that will be DC because the pattern that I need is on my different hatch folder. Let's see. Yung wood hasp na lang. Although, bamboo yan, pero I just need the other pattern niya para hindi lang siya basta vertical na object. Okay. And I'll just copy. CO, enter. Okay. So, I'll click here. Okay, I need 5. Okay, there you go. Next, close ko lang to. I'll save it. Yung Soji lamp, hindi ko na po explain paano ginawa. Kasi, I know you can do this given na nasa midterm na tayo. Dito tayo sa may modular cabinets. So, this one has a height of 1 meter. Okay, so let's go back dun sa section natin. I hope hindi kayo naduduling or sumasakit yung mata when I pan. But anyway, O, enter. That's one, enter. I'll pick from here, going up. I'll just adjust this. And I need to go back with my AR03 layer. Create ng line. And I need to make a reference out of this. Okay, kasi ayan, shelves. So, I need to snap it perpendicular para to wed. Okay? And TR. So, I have to cut that. And TR also dito. Okay? And I need a line. Okay? So, I need a line dito sa gitna nito. So, that's M2P. That's 1 and 2. There you go. And perpendicular. Switch to AR01 and that's BO for boundary para pag nag-offset ako, mabilis po. Offset at 0.05. There you go. Burahin ko lang to. And offset at 0.01. Paloob. Okay. I'll pick my AR02 hidden. So, PL enter or line will do. Diba, pag ganito siya, ibig sabihin, nagsiswing siya. Okay? So, it's a good thing that you include that on your elevations and sections. Okay? That's the proper architectural drafting. Anyway, that's MI enter. I'll be selecting those four. Enter. Click 1 and 2. MI enter. I'll get the midpoint down sa baba. Okay? So, create na lang ako ng line doon. There you go. And I'll copy this kasi meron modular cabinet din po dun sa taas. Ito yon. Okay? So, I'll copy muna. Yan. Okay, after that, I'll press enter once I'm done selecting. Click midpoint or endpoint up to the perpendicular. Okay? Aha. I will shorten this. Yan. And, tanggalin ko muna to or burahin ko muna yung mga object na to. Okay. 1 meter to. Pero check natin dun sa reference natin kung ilan siya. DI, enter. Okay, so that is 0.50. Okay, let's stretch. Because this is 1 meter, nag-copy lang kasi tayo sa baba. So, S, enter. Okay, make sure na kung may tatamaan man, konti lang. So, I selected a portion of those cabinets. And I'll pick endpoint up to midpoint. Okay? So, that's way easier. Anyway, you can do polyline after that and repeat the hidden lines. Okay? Again, those hidden lines signify something. Okay? Para alam po na nagbabasa ng plano kahit wala po yung architect or supervisor. I'll stretch that line. And then, by setting again my layer to AR03, I'll create another line. Okay, there you go. I'm going to create bookshelf for this. Personally, I love to read and a bookshelf is a must. So, I have all this thing. Now, ang gagawin ko po is, I have, tatlo kasi to eh. 1, 2, 3, okay? Let's see. Balik tayo dito. And maybe I'll just adjust this muna. I do hope nakaka-follow kayo and hindi siya ganun kabilis. Let me know, okay? So, I can make adjustment with the way I discuss it. Okay. Offset lang ako. 1 inch lang, 0.025. Yeah. Okay. Then, I have 1, 2, 3. So, let's get the distance. Okay, so that's 1.025. Instead na magdi-divide pa ako, magko-compute pa ako lahat-lahat, I'll just have to type div. That's div or divide. I'll select this. Click enter. And enter number of segments. So, I want it to be divided into 3. Enter. So, hayaan lang natin yan. And quick save muna ako. I will recycle some of my objects from previous exercises. Eto. Okay. So, there you go. I'll pick this dito. Copy. Yan. I'll copy this one also. Sa baba. Yan. Tapos, enter. And I'll type M2P. Pick endpoint and intersection. Okay? Balik ako dun sa section natin. And I have the node, that's 1 and 2. Okay? Yun po yung pinang-cut natin earlier. Or pinang-divide. Sorry. Okay? Kaya meron tayong node doon. Once you're done using the node, I suggest you remove them. Okay? Minsan kasi pag nagpiprint ka, bigla sila lumalaki. Okay? Based sa experience na din po. Okay? I'll remove this. Okay, and I'll remove the other excess books. Yan. There you go. Tanggalin natin to. Yung space dito, i-move na lang natin pababa. Okay. And trim, trim, and trim again. Okay. There you go. And I'll make match property. So, select this and ayaw nyo ma-select dun sa baba. Anyway, sige, I'll just do that. Okay, and afterwards, I'll pick all the books. Since books lang po sila, they don't actually need to be emphasized that much. So, I'll switch them to AR01, wherein mapiprint lang po sila, manipis na manipis. Okay? So, I'll save it muna. And we have the mattress. Okay? So, let's see. So, the mattress is 0.20 or 8 inches. And the headboard is 0.50. Okay? So, let's go here. So, offset at 0.2. There you go. And I think I need to make another copy of this. Okay. And another line here. And F enter. 0.05 is fine with me. I'll just click multiple options so I can ayun, may nawawala dun. Ayusin na lang natin. There you go. Okay? Kasi naka-elevate ito. So, yun talagang balak ko dito is kung sa 3D, mayroon siyang ilaw sa baba para may konting drama. Okay? Kasi lahat naman tayo may drama sa buhay. Anyway, I have to offset this at 0.5 for the headboard and make some extend thing. Okay. So, I don't know, nakaka-follow naman kayo. If you have questions, you're free to speak. Now, for the headboard, I need pillows or cushion. Okay. So, I'll again recycle some of my objects such as this. Okay. So, I'll click. That's one and another one. Okay. Click. And I'll just have to switch this on another layer, AR01. Okay. And again, trim all those objects that are not needed. Ito. Okay. Then again, I need a wood pattern. So that's DC, enter. I have to switch on a thinner line weight, AR01, and double click. And click that. And the one sa baba, tsaka doon, tsaka dito, and enter. Okay, almost done. Next is my mural. So, please take note of this. I believe hindi ko pa siya naturo sa inyo. The command is ER. In the emergency room, it stands for external reference, or instead of ER, you can also type it XREF. Either way, okay? XREF enter. Meron kayong icon dito. Okay, when you click this, you can attach several file types. Pwedeng AutoCAD or DWG, pwedeng image, pwedeng DWF, DGN or PDF, but let's switch to image, okay? So, select image. Aha. So, ito po yung painting na napili ko. Class, make sure na pag nag-XREF kayo ng image, dapat yung CAD file ninyo kung saan nyo siya nilink o in-XREF at saka yung image na in-XREF nyo, dapat magkasama sila ng folder. Okay? Kasi pag hindi sila magkasama ng folder, inopen nyo ulit, hindi na siya visible. Link lang yung makikita ninyo. Okay? So, be reminded that the CAD file and the image file that you will be linking together should be of the same folder. Okay? Anyway, I'll just pick 1 and 2. I want this image to be fitted on this available space. So, I'll command for AL. Enter. So, I'll select this. I'll click endpoint to endpoint, endpoint to endpoint, and enter. Scale objects based on alignment points, or magre-resize ba, daw ba siya based dun sa mga endpoints na in-specify mo. Let's type yes for Y. And there you go. Meron siya lumagpas dito. So, anong gagawin? Ika-crop natin siya. How do you crop images in AutoCAD? You select it. Once the image is selected, you have the option here to create clipping boundary. Okay? So, click that. And you pick from here down dun sa baba. Okay. So, there you go. You have a mural or an oriental painting in your interior. Okay? So, I'll leave the discussion for that until there. So, the rest, alam ko. Alam nyo nang gawin. Close ko muna to. By the way, I have here, eto, a pagoda. Okay? So, how did I make the pagoda? Xref ulit yan. So, pay attention again. So, I have here, there you go. Lagay ko lang siya dito. Pag masyado siya maliit, yan, select nyo lang. Yan. And, you can select this one. You can adjust the brightness. Okay, you can adjust the contrast. You can adjust the fade. Okay, there you go. I have the pagoda. Paano ginawa ko yon? Hindi ko na mismo ito elaborate. I elaborate the pilu instead. Okay, I'll change my layer. I'll type REC. Parang babakatin mo siya. Okay, I'll just mirror or again rectangle. Okay, I'll mirror this one and this and this. Okay. So, ito na siya. And I'll just click onto that and to the other one also. Okay. I'll move it. There you go. And I'll just trim all those objects that I don't need. You get me? Alam ko you follow me. Nakukuha niyo ako. Okay, there you go. And I'll just group this. G, enter. And there you go. Meron na kayong figurines. Oriental figurines. Ito yun, actually. In-stretch ko lang siya. Okay, medyo I made it a slimmer one. Okay, so that's actually a pailu, a Japanese entrance gateway. Okay, let's try another one. This cherry blossom. I'll use, pwede siya ng arc eh. Ayun, sige. Arc. 1, 2, 3. Arc ulit. A ulit. A ulit. So, parang binabakat-bakat nyo lang siya. Okay? It doesn't have to be 100% nakapareho. Parang reference nyo lang naman kasi po yung picture. Okay? So, you can do so many of this. There was a time na pati yung sa manga binabakat ko dito eh. Yan, nabubuo na siya. Okay? Tapos, you can do flowers. Sige, try natin. You can do this with array. Or pwede rin ibang object, just like what the one that I'm doing. Okay? Hanggang mabuo niya yung bulaklak. Or, I have one. Let's see. There you go. I'll just copy this. And have it. Asan ba siya? Yan. Okay? So, if it's too big, you can just scale it. Maybe at 0.4. Okay, I'll have the 0.4 here. And I'll copy it and make scale ko to na medyo malaki ng konti. Sorry. 1.3. And I'll copy another one and have a smaller version of the same object. 0.5. Okay? So, CO. Yan. Lagay-lagay nyo lang dyan. Hanggang sa mabuo nyo siya. Okay, you can also have the bigger one. Yan. And you can have this somewhere here. Okay. Oh, there you go. Burahin ko lang to ah. Yan, almost there. Hanggang mabuo nyo yung sanga. Alam nyo nang gawin yan, okay? Sige. After that, you know how to put dimensions, okay? You can use this as your backdrop. Kasi sa akin, ginamit kong backdrop is image. So, you can use this one if you don't want an image, but if you want a traced elements out of 2D objects, pwede din naman po, okay? Doon tayo sa specs. Ito, dito. Let's start here with the modular cabinet. I'll switch my layer to AR03. Then type letter C for circle. I'll pick anywhere. Siguro track ko yan. Okay, so I'll type 0.025 for the radius. Ayan siya. And I'll create a line. Okay, straight line, probably at around 2.5. And lagay ko dito. Yan. And then afterwards, that's REC enter. Okay, so that's at 0.25. Or sorry, that's too big. 0.025, comma 0.30. Enter, okay? So I'll move this midpoint. There you go. And I'll copy this. Okay? So, you don't have to create a new text object. You can always recycle other objects para mas convenient po yung pagda-draft. Okay? So, I have that. And then type or double click to change the content. Modular cabinet. Minsan, kung meron pang separate detail yan, I even include here na C debt or minsan nilalagay ko C schedule. Okay? Next is, let's copy another one. Okay. For example, eto. Yan. Okay? And copy ko to. Maybe at 0.4. Fillet ko siya. And lagay natin Japanese mural. Okay? Copy this, probably dito. Okay, this is another 0.4. Fillet nyo, and that is plastered finish, CH 5-inch thick CHB wall. Okay? So, that's how you do specs. Although, merong ibang paraan, pero that's how I do it, which is acceptable. Okay? So, of course, you have to quick save from time to time. And, of course, dimensions. DLI. That's it. But, 2.68 lang to. Okay? So, pwede rin dito sa kabila, pwede kayong maglagay. DLI. Okay? So there you go. You know what happens after that. And save. And for the last part, punta tayo na layout. So this time we will be using A3. You are familiar with A3. So ano po ba yung sukat niya? It's 4.20. It's 420mm by 297mm. Okay, but this is portrait, so we need a landscape. So let's see. I'll move it somewhere here. I made another layer. So that layer is title block. Layer name is title block. Color is 254. Line type is continuous. And of course, that is of thicker line weight. So that is 0.80. I'll double click it to make it current layer. And then type REC muna. Hindi muna ako mag-viewports. REC muna. And then type at 0.420, 0.297. Enter. Okay? And I'll offset it half an inch. That's 0.0125. Okay? Yan. So, may reference na tayo this time. Magka-create na tayo ng viewports. Okay? But before that, lalagay pala natin yung name nyo dito. Ito yun. Okay? So, adjust natin to ng konti. Half an inch also. 0.0125. And create a rectangle also for this. And that's 0.125. Or 0.0125 pala. Saan siya napunta? Ulitin ko po ah. REC, enter. So, I'll pick here. I'll drop here. 0.0125. Enter. Okay? So, kayo na pong bahala mag-gradient at maglagay ng text objects dito para visible po yung name ninyo at saka yung section, saka yung ArcCAD, midterm plate. Okay? Now, once okay na yan, mag-viewport na tayo. So, set the current layer here, viewports. Type MV, enter. You pick from endpoint hanggang dun sa midpoint. Okay? So, you click. And you activate this one by double-clicking it. Hanapin natin yung floor plan. May in-upload na ni ma'am kanina pa. We will be using Z-Enter 1 over 50 XP. Okay? So, eto siya. Lalagyan nyo po ng caption yan na floor plan, scale 1 is to 50. So, you know the drill for that. Okay? So, hindi na po kayo bago sa pagli-label ng drawing. And another MV, enter. You pick midpoint. And papunta dito. Okay? Double click. This one is for the section A through A. Ito po yon. Yan. And you copy this. Or kung gusto nyo mag-MV ulit, pwede naman po. Double click. Pan. And, syempre, kung ano po yung scale ni floor plan, dapat ganun din po yung section. So, mag-match property na lang tayo. MA enter. You select this. And, click this. And, click that. Okay? So, ayun po yung scale na 1 is to 50. Plus, there are times na may lumalagpas. Okay? Ayusin nyo po. Please do not use a scale other than 1 is to 50. Okay? Para pag nag-check ako, hindi ako masyadong nagma-magnify. Para hindi ganun katagal yung pag-check. Okay po? Please use again scale 1 is to 50. Lagyan nyo din po ng caption dito. Say, section A through A, scale 1 is to 50. So, you know the drill for that. Okay? So, you're not new to labeling plans. And after that, we're going to convert it into PDF. So, that's Ctrl-P. So, the printer, the plotter, DWG to PDF. And sa isang section kanina, nakapag-set na kami ng A3. Though may existing naman na A3 dyan, but I want you to be familiar or I want you to know how to set a paper size because any paper size in AutoCAD can be set actually. Okay? Flexible po yung printer or plotter ng AutoCAD. Anyway, paper size. Punta tayo sa properties. Custom paper sizes. Of course, we're going to add. And start from scratch. Next. Okay, actually, andito na siya, 419 or 420, 297 millimeters. Kung gusto nyo pa siyang i-inches, walang problema. Pero mm po tayo, okay? And then, just click next after that. And again, we want to maximize the entire paper. So, you set everything to 0. Okay? And click next. So, let us type 3E underscore A, 3 underscore paper size. Okay? So, we're good. Just click next and finish and click OK. And hanapin na natin yung paper nyo dito. That's 3E. Window. Pick up there to the opposite points. And of course, ano nakaset dito po? Monochrome. Okay? Marami pa po nakakalimot neto. Apply to layout. And preview. We forgot one thing. The hidden lines. Okay? Ito po pala yung ano ninyo ah. Yung itsura niya. Pag nag-xref kayo. Okay? Colored po siya. Ito yung tinrace natin earlier. So anyway, I'll press escape muna. And another escape. And we have to adjust LTS. Na marami po nakakalimot. Pag nag-check ako, napapansin ko yon. LTS, that is 0. That's right, apat na 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, enter. Aha. Bawasan natin isa. Okay, there you go. That's perfect. So, we're good to... Pwede kayo mag-Control-P. Pero kung naset nyo na to at gusto nyo na lang siyang i-preview, pwede rin PRE na lang for preview command. Oh, there you go. Pareho lang naman po yun. Yan. Nakaset na po yung hidden lines. Okay? Then you do right click and you know what will happen next and what to do afterwards. Okay? Sige. I'll save this.